Dear students, today we shall continue the topic pointers. In the previous video on the pointers, we learned about what is pointer, how to declare a pointer, how to initialize a pointer, how to assign an address of a variable to pointer, how to extract a value from the memory using pointer, and also we discussed about arrays and pointers. So in this video, let us begin with pointers and functions. So in this particular topic, we will be learning how to use pointers with the functions while passing parameter using the call by address. So that is also called as call by reference. We actually pass the address of a variable to the call function. In the call function, the formal parameter should be declared as pointers with the same type as that of actual parameters. Any updates made inside the call function will modify the original copy, because we are directly modifying the contents of the exact memory location. Let us take one example to discuss about pointers and functions. So in this particular program, we are defining a function with pointers. The function name is swap here. So this particular function is used to swap the values of two integer variables using pointers. And the return type of this particular function is void, and this function is taking two parameters, and both are pointers. The first parameter is int star a. So this basically asterisk is indicating a as a pointer. Similarly, we are taking second parameter as a pointer, that is int star b. So like this, swap function is taking two parameters. And the definition of this particular function, what we want to do is we want to swap the values of a and b using pointers. So we'll take a temporary variable temp here, which is an integer value. Then we take temp is equal to a star a, that is asterisk a. Asterisk a basically gives us value of a memory location that is pointed by the pointer a. So the value of a memory location will be assigned to temp here, and a is, that is asterisk a is equal to asterisk b. It means the value stored in the memory location pointed by pointer b will be assigned to a memory location that is pointed by a pointer variable a, and finally we make b is equal to temp. So like this, the values of the two memory locations pointed by the pointer variables a and b will be exchanged or swapped here, and whatever changes we make here, it will be affecting the original parameters. So that we see here. Next, we have got the main function. Inside the main function, this swap will be called here. So inside the main function, the very first line is variable declaration. Here we declare two integer type variables, that is num1 equal to 5 and num2 is equal to 10. And after that, so there is a function call. So the swap function that we defined here, it has been called from the main function. Now, how this function is called, let us see. So this is a function name. The actual parameters are num1, num2. So in this case, we need to pass address of the variable num1 and num2. Because in the function definition, we have taken formal parameters as pointer variables like a and b. A and b are the pointer variables which are storing address of another variable. It means whenever that function is called, we need to pass address of the actual variables num1 and num2. So once we declare integer variables num1, num2, a memory location, two memory locations will be created in that 5 and 10 are stored respectively, and num1, num2 will be having the their memory locations will be having the addresses, and the address of num1 and num2 will be passed here. Okay, what happens is address of num1 will be assigned to pointer a, and address of the second variable num2 will be assigned to second pointer variable b. We know that, we already studied that whenever a function is called, the actual arguments will be passed to the formal arguments. Here the actual arguments are address of the variables num1 and num2. They are assigned to the actual, assigned to the formal parameters, that is pointers a and b. Here a gets address of the variable num1 and b gets address of the variable num2. And inside this function, what we do is we exchange the values of A and B. And whatever the modifications we make in the call function, it is also affecting original or actual parameters in the main function. Now, the address of num is assigned to A and the address of num is assigned to B. And the value stored in the num is 5 and the value stored in num2 is 10. And we are exchanging the values of A and B. So, once we exchange values of A and B, it is also exchanging values of num1, num2 in the main function. That is why after the execution of this function, once we return back to the main function and we print the values of num1, num2, and we found that their values are swapped here. Number 1 we got it as 10, earlier it was 5, and after swapping we got it as 10. And number 2, earlier it was 10 and after swapping it became 5. So that is how we can make use of pointers along with functions. Now let us compare call by value and call by reference. Let us understand what is the difference between call by value and call by reference. In call by value, the copy of actual arguments is passed to formal arguments of the call function, and any change made to the formal arguments in the call function have no effect on the values of actual arguments in the calling function. But whereas in call by reference, the location or address of actual arguments is passed to formal arguments of the call function. This means by accessing the address of the actual arguments, you can alter them within from the call function. The second difference is in call by value, the actual arguments will remain safe. They cannot be modified accidentally, because the whatever changes we make to the formal argument, it has no effect on the actual argument. Even if you modify anything to the formal arguments accidentally, but the actual arguments will not be modified. But in call by reference, and whatever alteration we make to the formal arguments, even the accident, it is also affecting the actual parameters in the call function. So that is why you have to be careful in case of call by reference. Whenever required, then only you need to alter the formal arguments. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is the pointer arithmetic. So that is basically we can perform certain operations on the pointer. All the operations we cannot perform on the pointer, but few operations such as arithmetic, a few arithmetic operations we can perform here. We know that pointer stores an address which is a numeric value. Address is basically an integer value. It means the pointer is basically storing address which is an integer or numeric value, and hence we can perform arithmetic operations on a pointer as we do with numerical values. So there are four arithmetic operations we can use on the pointers. First one, increment operator, that is plus plus. Second, decrement operator, minus minus. Third, addition plus. Fourth, subtraction minus. Fifth one is comparison. So only these five arithmetic operations we can carry out on the pointers. So let us begin with the first one, that is increment operator. We know that increment operator basically increases the value by 1, but in case of pointer, the increment operator, that is plus plus, increases the value of a pointer by size of the data type pointing to. So here when we increment pointer using plus plus operator or increment operator, its value will be incremented by the size of the data type. We already learned that the size of the data type will be depending upon the compiler or the computer architecture we use. For example, if the pointer is pointing to character type of data, then plus plus will increase the value of pointer by 1. What is the size of character? Size of character is 1 byte. If a pointer is pointing to character type, and if you increment pointer by 1 using plus plus increment operator, then value will be incremented by 1 because the size of character is 1 byte. Similarly, if the pointer is pointing to integer data type, then plus plus or increment operator on that pointer will increase the value of pointer by 4. The size of integer is 4 bytes. If you consider a system of a 32-bit data bus, then the size of integer will be 4 bytes. If you consider a system like a DOS system where we find the size of integer as the 16 bits, that is 2 bytes. It means the size of the data type purely depends on the system. And if you consider the size of integer type as 4 bytes, if the pointer is pointing to integer data type, and plus plus would increase the value of pointer by 4. Now let us take a simple program to increment the variable pointer to access each accessing element of the array. So in this particular program, we begin with hash include std.io.h, then we have the main function. Inside the main function, very first statement is the array declaration statement. So in this statement, we declare array and also we initialize the array. So in this statement, we are declaring an integer typed array with the name var, and that is initialized to three elements 10, 100 and 200. And the size of the array is not specified here, because automatically or by default it will be taken as number of elements that you are initializing. Here the number of elements we have taken is 3, and automatically the size of array will be taken as 3. So this statement is creating an array with the name var, and array elements are initialized to 10, 100, 200. It means array having 3 elements, 10, 100 and 200. Here we want to access array elements using pointers. In the next line, we are declaring an integer type variable I, comma a pointer variable ptr. We already learned how to declare a pointer. It's a data type, asterisk, then variable name. So I is ordinary integer variable, ptr is pointer to an integer. So this basically star makes a ptr as a pointer. So this ptr can hold address of another variable. So in the next line, what we do is the array has been assigned to ptr, that is ptr is equal to var. So we already studied that array will be having the base address. What is base address? Starting address of the array, that is address of the array's first element is called as base address. So that will be assigned to ptr. Assume that the array's base address is 1130. Array's base address is 1130. And also assume that the size of integer type as 2 bytes. Now let us see how it is going to work. Here we'll take ptr is equal to var. It means base address of the pointer will be assigned to the variable ptr. The pointer variable ptr. Then we'll take a for loop. In the for loop, we will start from I equal to 0, I less than 3. There are 3 elements in the array, and I plus plus. So this for loop is going to be repeated for each element of the array. So it is going to be repeated 3 times, starting from I equal to 0, and condition is I less than 3. The loop is going to be repeated until I is less than 3, then I plus plus. And inside the for loop, we are printing address and also the value. Here address of the array element you want to print here. So that is what, in this particular printer, you have taken address of var a percentage d. Percentage d is basically a placeholder. So that is replaced with value of I. Initially I will be 0. Okay, 0 less than 3, condition is true. Since the condition is true, enter into the for loop. The first statement is printed here. It is going to print this message here. That is address of var a percentage d. So percentage d will be replaced with value of I. I is 0. So we'll get it as address of var of 0 is equal to we'll take percentage x. Do you know what is percentage x? So it is basically same as percentage d, but we used to print unsigned integers. You know that whatever the memory address is you want to print here, those memory addresses will be unsigned integers, positive only numbers. Okay, to print unsigned integers, we'll use percentage x here. So the percentage x will be replaced with PTR. So what PTR is holding? PTR is holding base address of the array, that is 1130. So we print address of array's first element, that is var of 0 is equal to 1130. That is the base address assigned to PTR. Next, let us print the value stored at that particular memory address. Again, there is a printf statement here. So we will take the value of, then var of percentage d, it's a placeholder that is substituted with the value of I. So since I is 0, we got it as value of var of 0 is equal to. So this time we have taken a percentage d as a placeholder. They actually want to put the value stored at the address 1130. So we can extract the value stored at the address or memory location with the help of asterisk operator, and then followed by pointer variable name, that is star PTR is going to extract a value stored at the memory location that is referenced by the pointer PTR. So the value stored here is 10, that is the array's first element, that is 10 will be printed. And after that, to move to the next array location, what we do is we increment the pointer by 1 here. So in this particular segment, we are making use of increment operator plus plus. It will be PTR plus plus. What it does is it will increment pointer by 1. It will increment pointer by 2 here, that is size of the integer type. We assume that the size of integer is 2 bytes. The address of next memory location of the array is 1132. After incrementing pointer by 1, the pointer will move to the next memory location whose address is 1132. What we do is, and we come here, increment I by 1, I was 0, it became 1. That's the condition, 1 less than 3, true. Again, these statements are executing once again. So it is printing address of that is var of 1, that is array second element whose index is 1 is equal to 1132. The base address was 1130, but after incrementing pointer by 1, we got the next memory location as 1132. So that is, its value will be incremented by size of the integer type. So we have assumed that size of integer is 2 bytes here. So the address of the next memory location we got as 1132. So similarly, we print its value using the star PTR. So the value at stored at this location is 100 here. So that is second element of the array. And after that, we go for PTR plus plus. It will move pointer to the next location. So the current location is 1132. After incrementing pointer by 1 using plus plus operator, it will point to the memory location whose address is 1134. That is, this pointer is incremented by 2. That is size of the integer type. We assumed it as 2 bytes. We come here I plus plus. We make increment I by 1 here. And I became 2. Check whether 2 is less than 3. Yes, condition is true. We come here and we print address of the third memory location, that is var of 2 is equal to 1134. And value stored at var of 2 is star PTR is basically printing the 200, that is value stored at the memory location whose address is 1134. It will be 200. And after that, we increment pointer by 1. It will be pointing to next memory location. So it will be 2 more than 1134. It is basically pointing to 1136, which is basically not exist. It is out of array bounds. And we come to incrementing I by 1. I was 2. After incrementing it by 1, it became 3. Test the condition, is 3 less than 3? False. Condition is false here. And we come out of the loop. So that is how we can increment pointer variable with help of plus plus operator or increment operator. So similarly, we can make use of decrement operator. So decrement operator decreases the value of pointer by size of the data type the pointer points to. If the pointer is pointing to the integer data type, then the decrement operator minus minus will decrease the value of pointer by 4, if the size of integer type is taken as or considered as 4 bytes. Then the final value of the pointer is calculated like this, that is current value of the pointer minus 1 into size of the data type. So let us take a program to demonstrate the decrement operator on the pointers. So we'll begin with hash include std io.h. Then we have the main function. Inside the main function, we are declaring some variables here, that is int a is a ordinary variable. Next one is a pointer variable. P is a pointer variable because it is declared using star here. So this p can hold address of a variable. So that is why in the next statement we have taken p is equal to ampersand a. Ampersand is basically acting as the address of operator that we already studied in the first video of the pointers. So here the address of the variable a is assigned to p. Now p is a pointer which is holding address of the variable a. Now let us print the value of p. So p is, the value of p is nothing but address of the variable a. The value of pointer p before decrement. Okay, we have taken the percentage u, so that is for unsigned integer. So there we print p here. Okay, p will be substituted here. If the address of the variable is 3472147, it will be stored into p, and the same value as we have printed here. The value of pointer p before decrement was 3472147, and after that we decrement pointer by 1 here with the help of decrement operator, is p minus minus. P is a pointer whose value will be decremented. So after decrementing pointer with the help of decrement operator, its value will be decremented by 4 here, if you take size of integer type as 4 bytes. So that is the final value of the pointer is equal to current value of the pointer. The current value of the pointer is 3472147 minus 1 into size of the data type. Size of the data type here is int here. If you take it as 4, it will become like the current value 3472147 minus 1 into 4. It will be 4. So 4 must be subtracted from this value. So we got it as 3472143. And let us print the value of the pointer p after decrementing pointer. So the value of pointer p after decrement. So if you print p here, we got value of 3472143. So it is 4 less than this above value. It means so this decrement operator is going to decrement the value of pointer by 4. So that is the size of the next operator we use on the pointer is addition. So we call this pointer addition. It is possible to add an integer number to a pointer variable, and the final value of the pointer can be computed with help of this particular formula. Final value of pointer is equal to current value of the pointer plus integer number into size of the data type. Now let us take a program to demonstrate pointer addition. So we'll begin with hash include std io.h. Then we have the main function. Inside the main function, we declare the variables here. So int a basically declares a as a integer type variable, comma star p. P is a pointer because it is prefixed with asterisk. So p is a pointer which can store address of the integer type variable. In the next line, so we have taken p is equal to ampersand a, that is address of the variable a is assigned to p. If the address of the variable is 3472147, then p is holding that particular value. Now let us print the value of pointer before addition. Here we have taken percentage u, that is used to print unsigned integer. Whatever the pointer value we are having, it is basically address of name location, which is always unsigned integer. To print addresses, we usually make use of percentage u, comma p. The value of p will be substituted here. So we got output as the value of pointer p before addition as 3472147. The next statement is p is equal to p plus 5, and integer value 5 is added with pointer p, and the result is stored into p. And the new value of p can be calculated using this particular formula. So the current value plus integer number into size of data type. The current value is 347 to 147, that is address of A, the quantity is holding, plus integer number that is being added with the pointer P, so it is 5. It will be 5 into size of the data type. The size of the data type here is int here. Let us assume the size of the data type is 4 bytes. It will become like 5 into 4, it will be 20. 20 is added to the current value of the pointer. It will become 347 to 147. After this statement, the value of pointer after addition, we got it as 347 to 167, that is 20 more than this value. Similarly, we can perform pointer subtraction. In C language, it is possible to subtract any integer number to a pointer variable. The final value of the pointer after subtraction can be computed using this formula. The value of a pointer is equal to current value of pointer minus integer number into size of the data type. Let us take a simple program to demonstrate pointer subtraction. We will begin with hash function yesterday's io.h install main function. Here we have the variable declaration statement here, int a, comma star p. So it is basically declaring integer type variable a and the pointer variable p, and the p is assigned with address of the variable a. The address of the variable a is 347 to 147, that is assigned to pointer p. P is holding address of variable a. The value of pointer p before subtraction, if you print here, we call that 347 to 147. So that is before subtraction. The next statement here is p is equal to p minus 5. You are subtracting 5 from the pointer p. Now the final value of pointer after subtraction is equal to the current value of pointer, that is 347 to 147, minus integer number that are subtracting there is 5 into size of the data type. Let us take it as 4 here. It is 5 into 4. Subtract 20, because 5 into 4 is 20. So after subtraction, the value of pointer is 347 to 127, that is 20 less than this value. This next one is the comparison of pointers. It is possible to compare two pointers with each other only if both pointers are pointing to the similar type of data. Let us take a simple program to demonstrate comparison of pointers. So we will begin with hash into std::hello.h, then we have the main function. Inside the main function, we have the pointer declaration statement like int star ptr1 comma star ptr2. There are two pointer variables declared here, ptr1, ptr2, both are of type integer. These are called as integer pointers or pointer integers. So there is an ordinary variable a, and address of a is assigned to ptr1, that is ptr1 is equal to address of a, and ptr2 is also holding address of a. And after that, let us compare ptr1 with ptr2. For the comparison, we make use of if statement with the condition ptr1 equality is a double equal to, that is called as equality ptr2. Ptr1 is compared with ptr2. If the values of these two pointer variables are same, then it is going to return true, otherwise false. Since both pointers ptr1 and ptr2 are pointing to the same memory address here, that is address of a, so this particular expression will be evaluated to true, and this we print out that pointers are pointing to the same data. If these are pointing to different data, then we print pointers are pointing to different data. But in this particular program, both are pointing to the same memory address, that is address of a, means the pointers are pointing to the same data, that is output we got here. Now let us move to the next topic, that is the character pointer. Pointer to character is basically called as a string. So before that, let us learn there are two different ways to represent string in C. One we already studied, that is using array of character. An array of character ends with null character is called as a string. And also there is another way to represent characters, I mean strings in C, that is using pointer to character. So pointer to character is basically equivalent to array of character ends with null character. Let us take a simple C statement here to understand pointer to character. to store the string value. Character star a is pointer to character, it can be initialized to a string value, like the char star a is equal to hello. It is equivalent to creating an array with the character stored as hello and with null character like this. It means using a character pointer or pointer to character, we can store the string value. So the same thing has been demonstrated in the program. Now let us see what are the benefits of pointers in C and what are the drawbacks of pointers in C. The benefits of pointers in C include, first one, pointers provide direct access to memory. We learned that pointer is basically holding address of a memory location. So using pointers, we can directly access to the memory. Pointers provide a way to return more than one value to the function. Next one, reduces the storage space and complexity of the program. The amount of storage space allocated to program or used by the program will be minimum if you use pointers. Reduces execution time of the program. Since pointers are referencing memory location directly, automatically the execution of the entire program will be reduced. Provides an alternative way to access array elements. Array elements can be accessed either using array index, which is starting from 0, and another way to access array elements is using pointers that we already studied. Pointers can be used to pass information back and forth between calling function and call function. So that is what call by reference. In case of call by reference, the address of actual parameters will be assigned to the formal parameters, which are pointers, and whatever changes we make to the formal parameters is affecting actual parameters in the call function. So that is what call by reference that will be studied. The next one is, pointers allows us to perform dynamic memory allocation and deallocation. With the help of pointers, it is possible to allocate and deallocate memory dynamically. That is, during runtime, it is possible to allocate and deallocate memory using pointers. Pointers help us to build complex data sets like linked list, stack, queue, string, stuff, etc. That will be studied in the third semester. Pointers allows us to resize the dynamically allocated memory block. Memory can be allocated dynamically using pointers, and even it can be resized with the help of pointers. What do you mean by resizing of the memory? Memory that is being allocated, it can be either decreased, the size can be decreased or increased during execution time or runtime. So that is possible only through pointers. And the last one is, addresses of objects can be extracted using pointers. Let us see what are the drawbacks of pointers in C language. Uninitialized pointer is dangerous because that might cause segmentation fault. Pointer has been declared but it is not storing any value. So that is called as uninitialized pointer. So that may lead to a runtime error, that is called as segmentation fault. Dynamically allocated block needs to be read explicitly, otherwise it may lead to wastage of memory, that is called as memory leak. If you allocate memory runtime or dynamically using pointers, that memory can be, the memory must be deallocated manually at the end of the program. If we don't do that, that memory will be reserved to that particular pointer, that may lead to wastage of memory. So it must be compulsorily deallocated or free. And pointers are slower as compared to normal variables. If pointers are updated with the incorrect values, it may lead to memory corruption. So this is the end of pointers. Thank you.